today I want to show you how to add single color formatting and color scale formatting to a table chart. To access the configuration setting, click on the chart and go to the Style tab. And under this conditional formatting section, click Add to add a rule. Here for our first example, let's assume we want to color the table when the city name is Fort Myers. So in this case, we can select single color for the color type. Then for the format rules, we will need to add the condition where delivery city is Fort Myers. So in this case, we're going to select a field first. And here we can select delivery city. And for the condition, we are going to select equal to. Lastly, for the input value, just key in Fort Myers. Also, do take note that Data Studio is case sensitive, so the letter case must be exactly the same as the value in your dataset. Moving on to the color and style, here is where we can define the format to be applied to the selected area when the condition above is being met. So in the drop-down here, you can see the entire row being selected by default. If you click on it, you can actually see there are other options that you can set to color it. So for now, let's leave it as default, which is the entire row. And moving on, we're going to color this selected city to yellow color. And we can click Save to proceed. Now in this table, you can see that Fort Myers City has been colored for the entire row in yellow. So it's quite simple. And before I move on to color scale conditional formatting, I also want to mention that you can set the condition using the matrix. So earlier we are setting the condition using the dimension, which is the delivery city. But now we can move on to set a condition for maybe the sales revenue. So for example, we can choose to color the entire row when the revenue is more than 35, for example. So now we can go on to edit the rows by clicking on this edit button. Now click on this edit button again to edit this row. Here, instead of delivery city, now we're going to select sales revenue. And then for the condition, I'm going to select greater than or equal to. Under the input value, just key in 35. And for the color and style, this time I'm going to try different one. I will reset this color to the default. And then for the font color, I'm going to select green. Then we can click Save to proceed. Just cross this window. Now you can see the text format for the table has been changed based on the condition that we have just set. Now we have learned about single color formatting for metrics and dimension. Next, we'll be learning how to set color scale conditional formatting for the table chart. First of all, we can go to select the table and go to style and add a rule. Before I do that, let's remove this rule so that it's clear for the next one. Just click add a rule and then we are going to come to this same page. Now instead of selecting a single color for the color type, we are going to change it to color scale. For the format field, we are going to choose sales revenue and we'll leave everything at default and proceed to click save. Now you can see that the color scale has been applied to the entire column for sales revenue. So the higher the revenue is, the greener the color will be, and the lower sales revenue will appear in red color. Now we'll go back to the setting to explore more options for the conditional formatting. So click on this edit rules again. And click edit again. Now we are back to the same page. So here for the color scale, instead of the default one, you can actually select other options like this one if you wish. So here's how it looks like if you apply a different color scale. You can also reverse the color scale so that the higher sales revenue get the darker color. But I'll prefer it to change to the previous one. And then we'll follow this Likert scale. Oops. You can see that now we have 3 points over here, which means Data Studio will use the points to determine how they should color the values. Now, instead of using percentages, we can change it to use number instead. So it will be based on the absolute number of the sales revenue. To show you an example, now we are going to change all the points to be based on number. And for the numbers option here, I'm going to remain as it is and click save. You can see that now we have more yellow shades for the numbers. So if you ask me whether we should select numbers or percentage for the point, I would say if your data is following something like Likert scales, you always have a minimum of 1 and a maximum of 5, then you can use number for the conditional formatting. So I hope this gives you a little bit of insights which option to choose. So that's all for today's tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.